Hello chess lovers, welcome back to our channel Chess Master. I hope you all are taking proper safety measures in this corona pandemic. Here we have continued our chess opening series. In this video, I have shown what to do after when you go for a worse happening on a chessboard and how you can do things better after it. So watch the video till last and also enjoy the video. And yes, if you want to challenge me, then DM me on my Instagram. At last, like the video, share it and subscribe it. And press the notification bell for never missing our upcoming videos. So chess lovers, let's start today's video. Now chess lovers, focus on this particular situation of a chessboard. In the game of chess, I tell you many times that there must be at least stages. First one is opening, second one is middle game strategies, and the third one is the end game. And I tell you, it is a series of the opening, okay? So we talk about many of the opening strategies, that how we open our pieces in a well manner and all that. But sometimes, due to our some of the stupid moves, or you can see that we can't always go for the best openings, okay? So what to do if we perform worst opening in some of the matches? And that's why this video deals only on that thing, that what we have to do when we perform worst opening in some of the particular matches. Because when we perform the worst opening, then at that particular position, first of all is that already intense pressure is get to be created on your side during the beginning. And the second is that your king will be get to be the unprotected conditions, okay? So these type of problems can be generated. And also one problem can also be generated that your more of the pawns are going to be captured during the opening, okay? So at this particular situation, more about around 50 to 60% match is get out of you from your hand, okay? So there is only 40% probability that you can easily win that game, okay? So how can we win that particular game in which we perform sometimes the worst opening, okay? So let's discuss. In that particular game, I was black, okay? So my opponent go for his pawn to d4, and I basically take my pawn to d5. And at that particular position, in the second one, he takes his pawn to c4, okay? So at that particular position, I basically capture that particular pawn at c4, which is not a very good move, because from this particular condition, you can see his next move is pawn to e4. Now pawn to e4 basically what? Controlling the center squares, and I can't protect that center squares, and can't do that. I control that center square at that particular position, okay? So at that particular position, I play the move of e5, because if the pawn captured that pawn at e5, then entire d-file get to be opened, and at that particular position, I basically captured his queen from my queen and cancelled, and then our opponent's king can't cancel there. And I also, at that particular position, the game will be around about 50% probability that I can win that particular thing, okay? But at that particular position, he basically captured my pawn at c4, and at that particular position, best move is I basically captured his particular pawn at d4, because at that particular position, his queen can't capture that, okay? So after that position, you can see that his pieces, like one of his pawn, it get to be developed here, and one of his bishop at c4 square is also developed in a well manner, okay? But myself, I can't develop my minor pieces from the move 4 also, okay? After that, now I'll tell you that first of all, your center square has been gone. The control of center square has been gone, and the next attack is the attack on your king are get to be start from now. And at that particular position also, I again perform mistake and take my pawn to c6, because at that particular position, the best move can be my knight to c6 is the best move. Why it is the best move? Because at that particular position, you are also able to save your king, but also your knight is get to be open. But when I take my pawn to c6, then at that particular position, my knight it gets to be useless there, because now he only go across D shadow square because the A shift square is of the out of the bold region. Okay, after that he takes knight to f3, and at that position I take my knight to f6, and he takes again knight to e5, and that definitely the next attack is going to be his knight to f7. Okay, but at that particular position I take my knight to e4, and he go for his knight to f6, and at that particular position I basically take my queen to f6. Now in this particular position you can see that my opponent is get to be fully dominated on me, and at that particular position if you see that I can't shape my rook at h8 square. Okay, means the game is only about 1.5 minutes and I am going to lose my rook here. Okay, so that's why this type of worst opening can't be occur to you also, because it is a only this game of chess. Okay, sometimes you will perform a very good opening, but sometimes you go for a foolish mistake during the beginning, and the result is that you go for the worst opening. Okay, so what to do when you perform the worst opening? Okay, so at that particular position I take my queen to f6, and if you want to capture my rook, then in the next move I am going to perform the checkmate by putting my queen to f2 square. Okay, so that possibility is gone here. Okay, so at that particular position he go for a castle, and I take my rook to g8, and he takes his rook to e1 and pin my knight. So at that particular position I basically take my bishop to f5 for protection of my knight, and he again perform check by taking his knight to d6, and at that particular position I basically captured that knight, and in the return he captured my rook, which is bishop at g8. Okay, after that I basically take my knight to d7, because now the first position is that what to do when you perform a worst opening. First step, when your opponent get to be perform attack on your side, so first do some of the moves so that his attack is get to be ineffective there, because at that particular position you can see that in this particular position my opponent is like fully dominated on me. Okay, that's why I go for the check method, and he have to save it, and I take my knight to g8, and when he go for his rook to e1 for further attack, I basically decline his attack with my bishop to f5, and basically when he go for his knight to d6 I capture that knight and he capture my rook. And it is common that when you perform the worst opening, then you have to lose your some of the pieces during the beginning. Okay, sometimes major pieces and sometimes minor pieces and sometimes queen also. Okay, so after that I take my knight to d7. Now at that particular position you can easily see that all types of attack that my opponent can perform to myself is now declined. Okay, so it is the first step that what you do when you go for a worst opening. So the first step that I basically save my king, okay, by his attack. Now after that I'm he takes knight to d2, and I perform a castle here. Okay, so when I perform castle, and then at that particular position he takes my knight also at a position of e4, and I also take his knight at e4 square, because at that particular position when he captured my bishop at e4, in the return I basically captured his bishop to g8. Okay, so two of my minor pieces also gone, and two of my minor pieces are also gone at that particular position. So no profit, no loss. So at that particular position you can see that he only have 13 points and I have 12 points, only 1 point difference because of one rook. But I proceed the way that takes off when you perform the worst opening. What to do? First decline his attacks, and after that save his king. So by this process I basically want to come back in this particular game. Okay, after that when he captured my pawn at a square, the back move is jack to take your king to c7, because at that position he can go to the AI attached to perform check and want to capture my duke and furthermore he can also deal, okay? That's why. Now he takes his rook to d4 and at a particular position I take my rook to e8 and want to go towards e1 for checkmate threat, okay? That's why he takes his bishop to e3, okay? And at that particular position I basically build my queen to f5 square so that I also can go towards c2 and something else also, okay? After that he takes his pawn to b4 and I take my bishop to e5, okay? So when I take my bishop to e5, basically now each one of his duke are get to be pinned here, okay? So for protection of that he takes his queen to a5. Now at that particular position I can't capture his duke, because if I captured then in the return he's going to capture my queen at f5 square, okay? So if I capture his duke, then in the position you can see that at that particular position he have one queen and one queen and one knight, okay? That's why at that particular position I take my, and he also perform check here, so I go for my knight to b6 and he takes his bishop to f4, okay? So at that particular position you can see that at that particular position the time is 5 minutes and 3 seconds, but I take 2 minutes of thinking this move, because if he captured my bishop then I will capture his duke and further moves can be, then it is a perfect move, okay? But at that particular position if I can't capture his bishop and I also want to throw his bishop from my way, okay? That's why the best move is that pawn to g5, because at that particular position if you want to capture my pawn I will be return capture his bishop at g5 square, okay? And that's why he have to capture my bishop at e5, and basically it is all about the exchange offer of the bishop at e5 square that get to be occur here, okay? No profit, no loss, until and unless here, okay? You can see the points. After that he takes his queen to a3 and I take my queen to e6 and want to go for a checkmate threat, and at that particular position he takes his queen to g3 and because of that I can't move my duke for a further checkmate threat, because my duke is get to be pinned here. That's why I unpin my duke, because I tell you that whenever your pieces are get to be pinned, first unpin it, okay? Otherwise it will be going to be very disastrous for us, because if I don't go for unpin then the next move he can take his duke at e5, and if you take then I can't protect my duke at that particular position, okay? That's why I take my king to c8 and he takes his king to f1 position, and now I can't go for a checkmate here, because if I go for my rook to e1 then he will go to his rook from a1 to e1, and if I take his rook from my queen from e6 to e1 in the return he will capture my queen from his king, okay? That's why I take my knight to g4 and at that particular position he takes his rook to d1, and I get to know that he want to go for his duke to d8 for a further disastrous attack, and that's why I again go towards b8, because I want to go across a7 file, because I want to basically protect my king from the opponent's rook and queen, and that's why. So when he performs check at that particular position at d8, which is get picked by me from the previous move, okay? That's why the best move is that king to h7, and I basically save my king, okay? Now at that particular position he performed a very blunder mistake here by taking his pawn to f3, because in the next move I perform the disastrous knight fork between his king and his duke at the position of e3, okay? So basically I captured that particular knight and he captured him. Okay, now at that particular position, you can see that what to do when you perform the walls opening. Then say that first defense, okay, that you have to defend yourself when your opponents perform the attacks. Second with that, save your king, which I done. And the third with that, be patient. Don't be get panicked that he have two of the rook and I have only one of rook. Because sometimes it is a game of chess, okay? So sometimes he can also be go for the some of the foolish mistakes. And at that particular position, when he performs some of the mistakes, then you have to be alert there, okay? As I was in that particular match, that he performed this foolish mistake. And I basically take my knight to e5 and take its rook. And now it's in this particular position that I get to be come back in my game. Because in the next of the move, I take my rook to e2 and go for the further attacks. But my king it get to be safe in this particular position. That's why. So at that particular position, I take my rook to e2 and he goes for the attack and take his knight and take his queen to b8, but he get to be late in his attack because my king is such a safe zone there. And I take my king to b6 and at that particular position he can't perform any type of checks from his queen. Okay, now when he take his queen back, because it will be necessary move, because if he don't do this, then I basically take my rook to e1, perform check. He will go towards the upper rank and I only basically take my queen to further second rank and perform a checkmate. That's why. So he takes his queen to f3 and at that particular position, I basically take my queen to a2 and he again take his particular rook to d7, because at that particular position, then his next move that he want to take his queen to c7 position and perform more checkmate, but he forget to watch his checkmate and I basically take my queen to c2 position and perform the checkmate there. Okay, so it is all about the game that when you perform the holes opening, so at that particular condition what you have to do. First one is that defend your pieces and your king when your opponents perform various types of attacks during the opening, okay, because he go for the perfect opening and you go for the worst opening. Okay, second one is that save your king, okay, and third one is that be careful in the mid game, which I used to be awkward in this particular match. And the fourth and last one is that be alert for your opportunities in the game at that particular position. When he perform such a blunder there and I perform a knight fork between his king and a rook, which is such an opportunity, and if you miss that particular opportunity, then you can't win this type of match very easily, because at that particular position you can see that I have only 7 seconds and he have 4 minutes and 39 seconds, okay, but I also won that game. So just lovers, I hope you must learn from this particular game that what to do when you go for the walls opening, okay? And if you like it, then please share it, subscribe it, and thank you.